relax memang dia tak ada feeling lah. Bila baca tu, bila tengok balik, kita tak boleh baca ni. Sebab tu belajar dah hati ni semua all that things kan. Selalunya, kalau kita ask you, there are so many names in Malaysia and places started with kota. Have you ever triggered yourself? Why they call it kota? Kota actually, if you translate in English, it has city or town. Because we're talking about city and town, has a ruler, mesti ada rakyat kan? Malaysia mesti ada ruler untuk sumber ekonominya. So, kota is a tangible heritage. Kota, the thing, the one that can hold. But in kota also have intangible heritage, our budaya, our culture, people. This is the thing that's missing a lot. Because when I did study on the cultural property in Malaysia, they always focus on culture and heritage of non-Melayu. Because they can find the trace, they can trace the tangible of Malay culture. Because they say that the Malay culture, rumah berkandung, pokoknya, dah tak ada dibakar. Yet, I want to show you what are behind this. Next. This is not done by our artists. In the past, when they know that Melaka is a very strong base, of course they will send the spy, or kita panggil peninjau. Kan, dari barat. This is the artist, lakaran artist, the sketch by the artist. How Melaka looked like at that time, before Portuguese coming. Can you believe this? This is semua kota. Kota ni bukan dari kayu, dan dikata dalam cerita, always by timber or by actually kota Melaka, sebab was built by brick. Kalau kita tengok kerajaan Melaka suka dah tua actually from Melaka to Patani. Ini that the great of dia punya kawasan jajahan dia. And then kat sana kalau kita tengok nanti Azhar for the next one dia akan cerita kat mana kita ada lembah hujan tempat buat batu bata, the clean. Itu dia panggil the clean, tempat buat batu bata. Ini that the bata teknologi is not new for the Melayu. Sebab tu orang pantai, orang Melayu, ibu bapa kita pandai buat bata sendiri. Because they have inherit the technology. Ini that Melaka, it was like this. If you study about the city, old city, most of the city is a defense city. The same goes to Melaka, it's a defense city. Mesti ada fortresses, mesti ada wall. This has been drawn by the Western artist, not by Melayu. So, we have to believe that this is Melaka at the time. Ada dah ada semua. Betul ke tak? Tembok. Okay, next. This is Melaka. This is shape of Melaka at that time. Memang banyak kuat. Sepanjang ni ada semua Melaka-Melaka. This is written, this picture ni boleh tengok dalam buku compilation of daripada siapa. Apa nama ni? Compilation of the nanti yang bagi ni. Maksudnya di sini dia cari dokumen-dokumen lama. Even this dokumen can be found in ATMA. ATMA adalah UKM, all this dokumen about the Malay world. So did you see that Melaka at the time is very harmony and prosperous. Ada semua pokok-pokok where people can singgah untuk berterima pada masa tu. Semua dia bahasa ni bukan bahasa kita ni. Kita kena yang mulia ni semua bahasa dia. Bukan Lunchai, Lusa, apa semua. Rul 09. So, dah ada dalam kerajaan di masa tu. Dah ketika dalam bahasa-bahasa dia. Next. Okay. This is another picture ni kota Melaka. Lukis di belakang. Tak nampak sebab sebab kita menteri dari Lukis kan? Dan kita pakai kota Melaka. This is how the artist impression at that time. Okay. This is the shape. Logic or not logic, you have to think. Maybe we are not in the maritime field. Actually, when you want to travel by sea, you must understand about the wave, about the gelombang, air tau. Actually, the ship from the west actually cannot sail to kita punya tanah dan kita punya lautan. Sebab kita punya lautan, if you tengok the kapal-kapal yang dari east coast, kapal dia kan muncul because kapal dia kena membelah ombak. Tapi kapal Portugis datang macam ni. Can you believe or not? Dia tak akan sampai. Mesti ada somebody yang dah ajar dia macam mana kapal untuk datang ke tanah Melayu. Sebab nak melintas lautan India Pacific tu bukan mudah. Sebab kapal-kapal kita tengok in the Western Europe, dia cuma bayangkan Europe punya map kan. Lautan apa yang dia ada? Dia cuma ada ada Mediterranean, Atlantik pun tak bagi semuanya. They are not good in actually in sailing. Bukan sail lah, sailor kan. Sebab ilmu pelayaran is not their expertise. Because they are not being governed by laut punya kehidupan. Tapi orang di semenanjung, kita laut. Kita pandai berlayar. That's why munculnya cerita hikayat awal kita. Hikayat awal kita actually is a Melayu yang telah dibaptiskan atau dimuntadkan to help these people. Dialah yang mengajar ilmu pelayaran kepada orang-orang barat. Cerita tu tak pernah diceritakan kita, tapi dokumen ada. Kalau nak cari, kena belajar mesti. Kita jangan bangga kapal kat Melaka tu kita belayar. Sebab kapal tak boleh sampai macam ni. Because knowing the ombak tak boleh. Sebab tu kalau tengok di karang mana kapal-kapal yang lalu gelap-gelap sekarang, ada ke kapal macam tu? Tak ada kan? Mesti kapal ni yang muncul kan? Sebab dia ada strategi. Kapal from East Coast and West Coast are different in term of their apa structure. This is Melaka. As we special. Next. Okay, this is now the apa dia di sini apa dia di sini. They draw. Okay, next. Tak pernah. This is the thing as we repeated again. No? Kita tak pernah tengok pun gambar kapal ni. Kalau orang itu dalam menipu cerita kita. So, kita tak pernah dinaikkan. Datuk Bahama, Mak Kilau. Mana ada? Kita tak tahu. You tahu minyak kapal, minyak kilau itu macam kan? Datuk Bahama pun tak tahu siapa dia. Hu Adik, Hu siapa lagi nama-nama yang dalam Melayu punya dunia alam Melayu kan? Pak Sako baru-baru lah dia tu pengurangkan itu adalah daripada literature. Ramai yang kita tak tahu. In fact, saya pun tak tahu yang saya tahu sangat dembak. Sebab because that's the legend dan juga macam tu. Masuri pun tak betul atau tak betul. Betul ada atau tak ada. It's a legend. Tapi yang apa dia tak nak cerita. Dia cerita dengan benda yang kaya. Orang Melayu ni suka berkaya, suka bercerita. Angan-angan. Sorry, Naim, I still have to speak bahasa.
Okay,
this is also the image of Malik. Kan? Panglima-panglima. Of course lah, if you compare the panglima, the Western, they have the attire. This is only the movie, yeah. They can create it, but in the past, this is how our Melayu orang melihat orang berpakaian lain. This is what it must be somebody in. Sebab tu, they have the movies. They must have, this they represent who they are, actually. Who they are at what level they are. This is going to be the head of the askar, head of the soldier, no one. And then there are soldier, normal soldier, what not. Okay. This is a picture I get them from the internet lah. Now it show that all these Malay rulers at that time, they have their special orang kata attire to present as a Malay ya. Tak adalah pakai kurung, pakai kurung. Because at that time, this is Malay, this is Melayu. They want to show that they are great. Apa kegagahan dia kau guna barang. That's why dia putih on the soft tenggolok, keris mesti ada. Okay? Because this is to show dia the strength of the individual. Apa? The individual image. Next. Okay, one thing about gajah. Gajah is normally, the elephant is normally right by the apa people lah, kaya kata ni, all the bangsawan, what you call short lah kan eh? Orang kampung tak biasa lah, tak naik lah. Now you imagine the transportation at that time was gajah. If the palaces was made by timber or lumber, can it be bertahan? Gajah kalau dia mengamuk, habis satu bangunan tu dia boleh rosakkan. It can destroy all things. Maybe at this time, all the building, all the palaces was made by brick. Tapi mana pergi ni? That's it gone. Kita cerita lagi. Kalau kita tengok logik lah kan. This is one of the kota-kota sejarah pasal dunia yang dimusnahkan. I have to highlight it because this is not in the book. This is my interest. Okay, later on nanti masa jajah pada bawah pergi jajah ke utara, you will show more on that dengan detail lagi. Because we have sent Azra and Luffy to jejak warisan to Perak and Kedah. Later on, they will show what they have got from their, their expedition. This is Kota Star. Imagine that. Kota Star ni, kerajaan Kedah pun tak ada jaga. Padahal it has a lot of history, a lot of significance untuk ke Kedah. Memang dia berhubungkan. Dan dia bina baru pula dalam tahun 2008. For them, it's nothing. But, Katalah all the UNESCO come and say this is the worst, they will do that. Why they are listening? They listen to the Western, the Western words rather than our own feeling of what we are doing. That this is more important to sustain, to show that this is the trace of our livelihood, of our culture. Okay, next. Saja itu nak tulis kota-kota Melayu ni. Kota Raja Melayu yang sudah pelabur kota sekitar kota Teluk Bahan. Pernah dengar tak kota ni? Tak pernah dengar, tak pernah pergi ya? Kita pun tak tahu. Kota Palas, Istana Sultan Maulana di Padang Mak Sirat Bulan Kami. Tak pernah dengar, tapi disebut kota. Istana Maharaja Jalil. Dekat mana? Ya. Kedah, ha? Kurung ke 16. Istana Tanjung Puteri, Kuala Ketil. Oh, Kedah mana? Ambil tak ada. Tidak ada. Tidak ada. Dan di situ masih terdapat Perigi Puteri Dayang yang dibina di sebelah kota tersebut. Because orang Melayu ni bila dia cerita dalam cerita dia, dia suka bercerita dalam bentuk apa? Dia panggil apa? Hikayat-hikayat. Puisi is okay, it's okay. Bukan puisi, sometimes they're telling about the, they try to describe the place. But they always, apa, kita ni tak ada benda yang catat dari mulut ke mulut. Sampai ke anak dari cerita lain, sampai ke cucu dari cerita lain. Jadi benda tu dah jadi macam satu storytelling, dah jadi satu apa kata dia panggil apa? Folklore punya cerita lah. Dia tak ada asas. Jadi sebab tu kita sendiri pun takut nak percaya. Tapi kalau kita pergi cari balik, benda-benda ada peninggalan yang sikit-sikit. Kenapa tinggal sikit? Sebab orang ni lah. Kan? Kita ada Istana Sultan Syed Sultan Abdul Kadir Shah Alam. Ha? Kurung ke 10. Bukan angkat Kedah. Kedah pun banyak misteri, banyak sejarah. Kota Pagar Air, Istana Sultan Hussein juga dibumbung ke Kedah. Ada Kedah. Istana Datuk Paduka ni. Nai Chow Shin. Tangkong Pulau Maharaja Kunjan. Kedah lah. Kota Sarjana, Alor Ganu. Kata Ganu lah, Ganu. Kedah juga. Kota Mumbuang, Puan Tepus. Ini dekat sempadan Siam kan? Puan Pasu. Memang ada. Istana Maharaja Melayu dekat sini. Pelik. Naji, ada. Ada peninggalan dia. Tiang-tiang ni apa? Kota Naga, Kota Siputih, daerah Kubang Pasu. Ada yang tempat eh. Kota Sarang Semut. Kota Sarang Semut. Pasal apa? Semua tempat-tempat kota Minang. Kenapa nama-nama di Malaysia ni dia suka ambil nama-nama kota? Adakah kota tu melambangkan is a place? Is a, it must be huge. Something that reflect. Sebab kita tak akan bagi nama yang tak ada kena-mengena. Especially orang Melayu. Dia akan, nama is reflect the place. So, di kota ni. Nama tak ada. Ketiga ni semasa. Kota Marung Mahawasa. Kalau muda. Mungkin dia nak cerita Marung Mahawasa kan sebab dia ada attack. Sebab dia tepi pantai along the dan ini the coast kalau kata dia ada mencerai kan. Along the coast line kan. Jadi dia nampak semua ni. Sebab that's why this is a very important kata legacy lah kalau kita tegak. Istana Majlis Raja Iskandar, Kota Kuala Muda. Ini semua ni tempat yang sama. Kota Kuala Muda, Kota Kuala Muda is actually is a great place lah at that time. Gok Arang semua ni. Okay. Istana Maharaja Melayu. Ha, senjata api pembuatan, senjata api mabuk. Kedah juga. Nah, ini yang melibatkan rangka suka of that thing. Istana Bendang Raja, Kubur Panjang. Kuala Kansa, this is in Perang. Ha? Kota Buha, Istana Raja Legit. Kedah. Kota O.O. Tahu lah macam mana sebut dia. Ha, dekat Sik. Kota Istana Bukit Nailong. Ha? Dekat Kedah. Jadi yang Istana Maharaja Melayu pun dekat Dusun Bandar Raja. Pada Perak Kedah. Istana because this was done, this was written by the person from Kedah lah. Mungkin dia study the focus on Kedah. Maybe kita pun boleh study on Perak, on Penang, ke mana tu kan? Okay, next. So, see? Nanti kota start tadi yang kata. This is a really next. Tak ada siapa pun. Ha, ini tadi avenue yang Kota Melaka, kalau kita imagine balik, this is Kota Melaka yang dilakar kan, yang tunjuk kita terus. Kota Melaka, kita tunjuk kalau kita letakkan lagi dia punya forest stress tu. Okay, next. Okay, Kota Kuala Muda. Kota Kuala Muda, ini dia yang dia tinggal di depan dia. Cuma kita dah ada ruin lah kita katakan. So bila ada ruin maksudnya ada benda lah. Takkan kita buat satu bangunan, satu kota ada pintu gerbang je. Mana kampung-kampung or where is the city inside there? It must be something. That's why people, kita kalau boleh lah as a lecturer or as a student, kita nak try mapping balik. Try to produce what was happening in the past. Remapping. Nah, try to map. When it has a gerbang, it has a gateway, it must masa yang sama dia bukan dari gateway ni menunjukkan kita nak masuk kan the entrance. So when you travel, tengok baliklah places apa yang ada kat sini. Bukan senang. So meaning that kita ada batu-batu dah. Bukan tak ada batu-batu. This is not new. This is very old what it was built in. Kota Palamuda sebagai kita saja sisa bina amal kita dah pada penjelajah dan penjelajah dan tak ada sebab kita tak menjaga warisan kita. Kota Nur Ibrahim. So this is brickwork in Perak. Why they keep that this brickwork? Because they want to show that this is the place where the justice was made during the assassination of J.W.W. Bush. And then they said that the Malay the world Malay warrior Maharaja Lela is a traitor. Adakah traitor among our people is a traitor to their own people? This is what has been judged. So they keep this as a sejarah because dia nak cerita W.W. Bush tu betul. Kalau dia tengok kota Nur Ibrahim ni, batu macam ni, takkanlah dinding yang lain kayu. Mesti ada batu. Tapi dia keep benda ni nak jadikan sejarah orang Melayu jahat. Dia tak cerita orang lain tu sebenarnya nak defend. Betul tak? Dia cerita diolahkan, dialihkan. Orang masuk rumah kita, biar ambil semua. Kita jangan buat apa. Kan? Is it our right? This W.W. Bush, they call the British person, come. Now, most of the people, when they come to our country, they rape the girls, they take all our wealth. Takkan kita nak penduduk diam? These 10 barang, all this warrior, of course, they fight. When they fight, they're being called as a traitor to these people, to the colonial name. Okay? So, they keep this. For them, this is important because for the history, for our history, it's also important to show that we also have a grand building at that time. Dia buat batu tak? Batu bata. Dia nak tahu sini sebab nak tunjuk keburukan kita. Next. Kota Raja Besiu. Kalau you tengok kota macam ni. Kan? Dekat Perak. Yang ditong sampah. Tapi kenapa Kadi Kasa tu dia tahu? Yang dekat Perak, Kelintan. Padahal Raja Besiu ni, kita punya buat raja. Raja orang Islam. Nama dia Besiu. Bukanlah dia Besiu. Agak gelaran dia. Why they don't keep this? Why they left it out? Yet they have all this technology. Why they agung-agungkan Western punya technology? See? Next. This. Kampung kota di Puas. Tinggal makam saja. Menghidap kalau ada makam, adalah benda. Adalah kota di sini sebab kota di Puas ni. Ini actually kota di Puas ni adalah pernah menjadi tempat, orang kata apa? State capital of Langkah Sukong masa tu. Tapi dia nak habiskan, nak hapuskan. Biasanya kalau when we found the tombstone tu, mesti ada orang kat situ. And then in fact, the tombstone ni from Aceh ni written in Jawi, in Arabic. Meaning that dah ada kerajaan, the trace. Cuma mungkin kita tak explore lagi. Next. Oh, Bira. Actually, I just put a few things kau kalau tunjuk gambar memang banyak. Cuma, this is the thing to trigger back. Why we as a Malaysian lah kat sini, never bring up our belongings, our culture property rather than putting up all the great of Chinese lah, Portuguese lah, yang kita dapat aman dulu kan. Okay, sebab, sebab rule and regulation is the Western. In UNESCO, they put down all the list, all the criteria, which is not met to our property. So, almost of the criteria is to their interest to show that they have come in. Of course, in the past, we agreed to say that Melayu are very hospitality person, very kind person. That's why they welcome many people to our country. Cuba you nak pergi negara yang bukan Melayu, senang you nak masuk. So to show that orang Melayu ni actually budi bahasa dia tinggi. Tapi it's taking advantage by this lah. So situlah saya nak tengok, nak ingatkan balik. Melayu bukan lemah, Melayu kuat. Bukan saya nak menaikkan semangat. Apa semangat tu? Kita orang Melayu ni, di mana kedudukan kita? Sebab if you look at that Syria macam di Palestine kan, di Iraq kan, see people even the prime minister of Germany kan, yang perempuan tu said that kan, orang-orang Islam kan, all the Muslim become the example, you can call it the asset, the liability to the world because they are migrate due to war, kan? But have you ever questioned yourself, who bombed the country? Who created the war? Whose order is that? Yeah. I think none of the Muslim country specific has spoken about that because we are also afraid of that, kan? So in order to get the senses, you see that? That's why I'm looking at this different angle. When UNESCO was set up in 1964, start with the Venice Charter, they are trying to preserve all these old monuments, because most of the monument that been preserved, basically behind the scene was the Jewish people, not in UNESCO, meaning that in the past. Even if you look at the history, the label for the pyramid was the Jewish. That's why, when that thing being kept as history, behind the history is the Jewish. Even you went to everywhere, of course I want to see what the world political, but this is their games. Eh? That's why they would be here and there, they would be all the Portuguese, they would be all the Dutch in Indonesia and British. Actually, this is their game. And then, they want to sustain, they want to simpan, preserve, want to show that they have been here. Even in Macau, it's a Portuguese, has been colonized by Portuguese. They want to keep that even in Spain, Philippines, it's a Spain colonizer city. They keep all these colonial town as good as they can. Even they find funding the project, not to sustain their legacy. Masih pun sama lah. That's why they funding Macau, tak buat benda kerja ahli lah, tak apa lah. Semua ada. And then they give money $200,000 for each state to preserve all this colonial legacy. It's only a little bit, not even 10% of Malay culture property being looked after. So this is you now, because you are interested in warisan, because we're talking about warisan, heritage. So your heart also must put in that line. Jangan pula tiba-tiba nak buat lain. So, kalau you have not started, you not reading the history, you don't know the history, this is what happened. Sooner or later, by 100 years, no more trace of the Malay culture property. Let alone our figure, our features. Maybe after we mix married with even somebody from somewhere else. The Malay feature, we don't know whether I'm the right Malay feature, you are the right Malay feature, we don't know. But as long as we are living in this Nusantara, Southeast Asia, Indonesia, Java, even Philippines, Thailand, Cambodia, we are to call it Malay, yeah? Malay, tanah Melayu. Okay, so sedikit lah yang saya dapat kongsi. Saya pun bila tak tahu, dia tak tahu buat ini, tak ada idea nak buat. Tak ada orang canggih. Okay, so before I leave this presentation, dengarlah lagu ni. Sebenarnya saya tak nak lagu ni, saya nak lagu Semerang Padi di Ramli, tapi tak boleh nama ni. So, Semerang Padi, cerita Piramli itu dia menceritakan macam mana hidup bersatu kampung Gotong Royong. Nak sebagi yang nak nasi, sebab cakap nasi nak datang. Just to go, asal tak payah pun yang ada kat sini semua pun ada dengar. Atau mesti kasih sikit
saya je. Saya ada yang lain.
Because I want to show that the Malay budaya orang lain actually lain tau. Kita ni terlalu baik, terlalu ramah mesra. Tapi kita terlalu bertolak ansur, tengok tu dia, Piramli lagi, azan. I nak tunjukkan tu, tapi tak betul. Tapi dia tak
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Thank you.